here we are back on Smokedown. Now, we're sold, supposing we've still got all the compost to sell, plus some more straw which can go in there. But I thought, we'd see if we can make a bit more money. Now, this field is full of beet, ready to harvest. Let me just double check on that, because I don't really want to be telling you all lies. Here we are, three, ready to harvest, remove top. That's quite a large field. So we're going to buy it. $200,000, I reckon we get we'd double that anyway on the beat. At least I hope we will. So from that, we're now going to go and hire some equipment. I can't remember which one. I think that's under standard beet harvest. I'm going to take the Homer. I'm going to rent it for 4 hours. I don't really need it for four, but we're going to rent for four. And we're also going to rent the header, of course, for another 4 hours. And I'm going to cheat slightly. I'm going to get it delivered. Wrong way. Header trailers. There we are, header trailers. And I'm going to rent the header trailer. I'm not certain I'll get the header through all the gateways, so it's going to be easy if I rent that and all. So the next thing is we just bring that lot onto the farm, reset, yes, and yes. Right, we're going to, that's easiest way would be, quickest way, we'll go back onto there and find that harvester. So yeah, enter vehicle, there we are. And that's there. Now we've got to get in behind. That's not always easy getting in behind these things. Well, it's damaged by it. I mustn't go too mad. But with the flexible steering on this thing, it does help quite a bit. I might get this there without needing the header trailer, but I'm going to take the header trailer just in case. Where is that header trailer? Right. So we come out this way. It's lifted yet. I'm going to get into cab. I'm not going to fold it. Basically, because if I fold it, I'm not going to see where I'm going. Not even certain which steering mode we've got on, but we get this here. I'm going to do most of the driving on this. I did think about doing the compost and all today, but let me just do this. This will just about end the day for us. Well, we got through that gateway. The boot of this thing is, it's going to make fairly quick work of it. I reckon I'm probably gone about 2 hours too long on my rental, but I've got to get it back to the garage, which is always a problem. And on the road, you have to take it back to the garage, because we're going to be travelling on the road. I will need the header trailer for that. I think I can get away without using the header trailer here. So far so good, we managed to do it without scratching it. And here's the field. Now I'm gonna try and do it so I can get in near enough straight into the field. That's the general idea. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna plant all maize, with the exception of the one field. Now quite a tight squeeze, with exception of the one field that had maize on last year. Right, we're in, we start over here, I think. I will just need to get a track and trailer set up, so I'm going to set that up next. I've got that ready to go. think I'm going to need to come out of cab to see how far back we can afford to go. I think that will have to take us. So I'm going to leave that there, put back on the four-wheel drive, put the brake on, and find myself a tractor. Oh, this one. What else we got? We've got that one there. That one's over at the BGA. Ah, this one's here, and it's got a trailer on there. I'm hoping this trailer will take Beet. If not, I think we'll take the other one. We'll take this one. We'll check on what. I don't think it's not the grain one. I think it's possibly the manure body for Beet. That's all as it may seem, but we'll try it anyway. One of the bodies will take Beet. We'll just get this over to somewhere near the field. I'm not certain I'm going to attempt the four tractors and trailers carting away from Solid, but I'm determined to fill one of those BGAs up and just see how much the dusty thing holds. So every field we got, with the exception, I think it was 9, which had the had the maize in last year, is going to have maize in this year. 9, I shall put a straw crop in there, crop and get some straw out of. Just hop in there. What I'm going to do is on 7 there, which is a grass field, I am just going to drop a quick quick heap on here, because I'm not going to take them back to the farm. It's going to be simpler just to put a placeable heap in, and if we put that about there, that will do. That will do, because we've got now we've got that in place. Now this can wait here until it's needed. I'm not going to try and take it in the field just yet. It will come in the field later. One place is not glidable hedges. I wish I'd known that earlier. I wouldn't have bothered to get that in quite so carefully. Right, unfold harvester. I do like this. I'll use it a bit, but I haven't really used it enough. We're still waiting, I think, to see whether it's going to be home on 17. I hope so. Take the brake off and away we go. And this is basically what I'm going to be doing this episode, is just getting this load of beating. I did think about one or two of the other fields, especially those with the gateway to near the end of the BGA, but I got a feeling by the time I'd harvest, or got around to harvesting, they might have withered the crops in there. So this, we'll take advantage of the giant thing that the root crops don't seem to wither. So we've got plenty of time to do this. At least in my experience on one map, I was trying to wither the root crops and they damn things would not go. I think it's on the Churn Farm map. I had other issues on that map, so I gave up on it in the end. So this is going to be a nice gentle little thing. I could put this on the auto combine once I've got a couple of laps done, and just have the drive the tractor, or put the tractor on the course play to tip off at the point there. In fact, I think once I've got a couple of laps, I'm going to put the tractor and trailer onto course play. And just continue driving the harvester, and I haven't got to worry about it. because of the amount of equipment we've got on this farm now, it's getting a little bit difficult to keep up with everything. And tabbing through, especially to get to this, which is not on a tab, so I can't even speed around. I'm not going to put it on a tab at the moment. It looks quite a decent crop of beet. Of course, we're according to the thing, we're only on the second day. Not very realistic, I realise now, isn't it? Shut off that for a moment. I'll come out now. I'm not going to risk us the main road there. These will be collidable hedges this side. So we can just turn into it. Yes, we got it. If we leave a food beet behind, it isn't going to matter. Because in the old days, you'd bring your sheep or cattle out onto the beet fields once they were harvested to forage for themselves. Now we tend not to. I'm not certain how much that little stirrup holds. It's probably about 16, 18 thousand, I would have thought, on that body. So I'll get this to about half full, or at least get it round to the entrance and change it. We're empty this off. I could use crab mode, but I keep forgetting when I'm gonna empty it that it's on crab, and I've got to put it back to normal mode. So I'll leave this on. I think it's on turn steering on this. I could put it onto flexible, I suppose. Might make it easy to get around the corners, but it shouldn't be too bad once we've got the about three headlands done. Oh, we're coming around to the start now. We just get it just past the gate and we'll see how much we can get the trailer holds. Some reason my mind had told me we've gone past the opening, but we haven't. We've gone past it now. Poor old soul. Right, we stop there. I can't lift on as we turn it off again. And we will get the pie boat, which is don't think I've got that set to a key. So the reason we're doing it here is I shouldn't have so far to run to get back to the track and trailer. Oh, won't go. I wish I'd have checked that. Hey, Joe. Yeah, didn't go in wide enough. Right, we could put the gateposts got collisions on. Let's straighten up so we can straight in. These are very tight gateways here. Shouldn't be as tight as I made it look, but they're still quite tight gateways. I'm going to cut the cab so I can... Alright, it doesn't look like a set one, so I will put it on. Oh, is that one you have to manually... Oh, we're not actually on the thing, that's why. We haven't gone further enough. I was right, it's manure, I just hadn't gone firm enough. I don't think this is a very big trial of this. It's going to be about 20,000 by the looks of it. I'll get the combine out of the way, or the harvester out of the way, then remove that out. And so once we get about... Once we get the headlands done, we'll set the tractor and trailer up onto course plane and hope it does a better job than I have. This is one of those nice little relaxing jobs. So we've gone all out in the, well, just over a month before 17 launches to try and get as close to the 3 million as we can. So we've gone for the big money items, but not forestry. Please, not forestry. I've done some of that on Paradise Hill. It's okay, but I think Paradise Hill is my lot for doing forestry on at the moment. But we're going BGA route on for this. I'm hoping I can get that done in good time to at least get the get it into the BGA itself. Well, we're all the way down here. I'm just going to stop this here. Switch it off. Now we're going to go back onto this. Now we could cheat and actually drive through the hedge, which would be feasible. And where's here we are. Trying to find the gateway again. Let's try and get it straight as we can. Over to the tip point, which is up here. There we are. Also, I will need to get a couple load into that tip point to see how close we can be. I'm just flashing through now to get back to this because I believe that tip and this is still one of the joys of 15 is home a pack. Yes, it caused a few problems with things like course play when it came out. Course play did not like it all. But the course play guys got busy and fixed that up, and latest news, they will be working on course play for FS17. That stopped that stopped all development on 15 and went for 17, and when it comes out they will start work on it. They have to wait until it comes out because they don't get advanced copies. They buy it like you and I, and then try and get course play to work on it. They're thinking they might have the first out late November at the earliest. Don't hold me to that. And to Sean and Chad, that is lemonade I'm having again. What else? Go in there. If I remember right, they've got to be very careful there. It's fairly close to the edge. Look at that F1 menu, I'd say. It's right in my way. I think this time we keep going until we fill this up. be the quickest way, I think, and it should be almost the headlands done. Not so I'll get up if I need 3 or 4, but we'll see. Then I'll shove this up. Then I'll shove the tracking trailer onto course play. In fact, I might do it at the end of this this time when we empty it. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to finish this up off screen because I'm fairly busy at the moment with other maps, both Heritage and Aldridge, which are carrying on into FS17 and possibly beyond with the Aldridge. I take quite a bit of my time. I was all weekend sorting out something on Aldridge for the Saturday episode, which is a rather special one. It's number 100. And getting on with that, advancing the story and trying to make it a little bit different for the 100th episode. It's a long time to be on one map. But the funny thing is, I still enjoy playing Aldridge. I know some people say, well, I get bored after a while. I make up little stories, as you well know. Even when I'm playing off screen on other maps, I make up little stories in my head to why am I doing this? Should have done an up and a down there. Oh, we're like only 40% at the moment. I think we'll stop here again and we're going to back up a little bit. Well, switch the head off. We're going to go back onto the track and try and we're going to set up course play. For those who don't like course play, sorry, but that's the way it is. I use course play because I like using course play. Not because I'm particularly lazy, which I probably am. But I don't quite see why you can't use something because it's there. Now, we know this hedge here doesn't collide, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to have to start point this side so it should go wide. Find it doesn't hit those trees or the gatepost. It should be okay. Now we're going to switch off the course we've got for it. This is that one, I think. Start combine. Right, so we'll come back to here. I'm going to do it so we're just on the unplanted part of the field, the part we already have. Now we're going to drop this off here and we're going to come past this now. Now what I'm trying to do, I don't want to go too close, but I want to be close enough so that's going to trip it. We ain't going to tell whether it's trip it or not, but it looks like it did. Now we just come back here. Very simple little course. And we got ourselves completely lost. Going the wrong gateway, so we will start again. We're not first you don't succeed, give up, I say. Okay. Fun and games when you're talking and trying to do something. I went too far now. Pick up the course again. We'll do the same we did last time. In nice and close. This will be the start. And this bit, It's okay. I've got a bit worried there, but we should be able to, don't go too fast. And we're coming reasonably close, but we don't want to be too close to it. Yeah, let's take the trigger. Now we're trying to go all the way around and hit the right gateway this time. And we need that where it's going to park itself. And I think we'll park it about here. Alright now. I'll make a search now. We want the Chromebag X Homer, that's the one. And we will start at, I think we're, oh, I'm not so keen on that. And we put this on to four wheel and we drop course, and it should now, just waiting for it. I think we've just have a good time to see whether this works or not. Take the brake off again and then put it in the forward gear. Yes, I know got the stage. Don't get back to 17, you know, looking forward to it. Now, at first I was a bit, may not be anything special, just 15 was a few whistles and bells, but it looks quite good. There's some things I'm really looking forward to trying out, and it's not the train, believe me, it's not the train. In a farm sim, you would not be, you should not be train driving. And what I'm also waiting for in the Farm Sim series is a British map coming in from Giants. I think they might not want that because they are very odd shaped fields with the hedges right up to the edge of the field and trees all around. They may not be too keen for that. That won't help their hide help one little bit. Yeah. We've probably seen the fun and games I had with them. Running course play at times to try and get, do what I want. Yeah, I think what we, all we're going to do today is a couple of rounds. I've got a horrible feeling we might be on this for the next episode. But what I will do on the next one is I will start the compost selling at the same time. And I can always put this on to auto combine to get the field done whilst I'm doing other things. And I also need to get started on all three of the fields and start planting them. I'll put this alongside here again. This is a nasty little piece just here. This bit what sticks out on this corner. Probably went far too far. Should really wait. In real life, I'd had to wait for that to wind up fully. Luckily, we're not quite in real life, and how we're doing now. We're getting close to the tractor and trailer coming. I remember doing this type of thing on 13 and having, I think, using the little Brantner trailers. Were they Brantners on 13? Or the right small ones. And having four of those going on course play. And only just keeping up with the Grimmy. And in fact, I'm actually running this far too quick. He's moving now. I'm just going to take this down to about nearer that, and let's just put that onto cruise control. That's better. Seems at a slightly better speed. gone out now. Have I got the spout out? That's the question. No. Now why isn't he? Because he isn't in close enough. Now I've got to go and make adjustments. Now you're nowhere near close enough. Side offset. Oops, right. Try that. Just take off the course for a minute. Back it up. Let's see what happens now. Are we close enough now? That's what I asked myself. I think I'm going to answer myself no. That's closer. Now I think we need to bring that. Let's try on 3 metre. Take this off here again. Take it right back here, so got to run up at it. As you can see, course play is not the magic bullet. It does take a bit of work to get things right. Now let's see if she can do it this time. Are we too close now? We might be a little bit close. We are, we're too close. So, 3 is too close. Take it out. 3-6. Stop drawing the back up. What's wrong? I think we can go out a bit further. Actually, we take it right out to 4. Well, take it to 4. But at least that is working now. Right, we'll hop back. In this. And then we will hit the cruise control again and get going again. I'm keeping here. Spout out. Now hopefully Sammy will, once I can get past this. This is not unusual for course play. It's finding itself trying to go exactly the same way as the harvester, so keep harvester it thinks is in its way. We have to just keep an eye out when we get up this way, and there it goes. Now there was a bend that hits the gateway. Well, so far so good. And then hopefully it will start to tip when it gets to the right point. Can't really watch it, I have to watch it on the glance. Yeah, that's tipping. What I'm going to do is give it another fill to check that position of the track and try to come up under the spout is about right. On 36%, so once we've done that, we're going to call it an episode. Now we should get a couple hundred pound a ton for these, and we're already milled around 40 ton, and we're hardly touched this field yet. And I'll have to go out and sell, and I will manually sell again because I think it will reverse into the selling point. Sell it outright again, it's the easiest one to get to. than the dusty millers. And that's this, it's all about trying to see how much money we can make in a very short period. That's fattening chickens up there, everything else okay, yeah. He's gonna sell his eggs, I've got in the backpack. Right, and I have mentioned this so many times, I'm gonna mention it again. There will be a lot less videos going up when 17 comes out. I am going to actually play that more. I'm gonna tell everyone how I missed. I don't want to go too far this time. As I have mentioned far too many times, and I'm going to bore you all again, there will be two Old Ridge, one Heritage, one on FS17. I have a story mapped out in my head, which I'm hoping will work. And one of another game, if I feel I can do it justice. The game is not going to be announced just yet. It's still on pre-order, so when it comes out I will have a go at it, and it won't be a farming game. So if you're just a member of the channel for farming game, that will probably be another one you will have to miss. Of course I should put that, keep forgetting to put that back onto cruise. Let's lift that again. And yes, I'm not breaking, I'm just taking this back and forwards on the cruise control. Just to join the cruise control on Giants will be forward and back. I'm so used to that now that it will, really will beggar me up if you've got no cruise on reverse, which is, it's very handy when you're reversing the trailer. It's easy in trying to hold your foot to a particular place on the throttle, or even worse for your keyboard, when you've got no choice but to keep just blipping the throttle. Getting close now to even 60% nearest, damn it now. I should soon start going up and down, but I think I'm going to go round and round in circles. That's got to be simpler. And let's have the simple life. A little bit more lemonade. Another hot day here in Norfolk. I think the poor PC isn't going to like rendering this, but never mind. And I don't end up with a pool of molten plastic, I shan't be too worried. There it comes. Well, it's coming. Oh yeah, here it comes now. It's tetter run up at us. Yes, that's good. We got it this time. Perfect, so we can keep running. And let course play figure out whereabouts we are. We've unloaded again. Just going to let course play run that course again. Double check it works. But in the meantime, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. If you like what you saw, please consider leaving a like. It helps me, it makes me feel wanted. If you're not a subscriber and want to see more of this type of mumbling work, then please subscribe. At the moment I'm doing this most days a week. The food should be a few less. I decided that I need a bit more time to actually play other games. If you have any comments, questions, queries, suggestions, feel free to post them in the comments. I try and read every one. My phone, YouTube will let me. It does play it on me now and again. And I try and reply to everyone. Good, bad or indifferent. With that, it's me, I'm saying cheerio for now. Cheerio.